come back, we are now looking at the travel graphs where we are getting the acceleration, retardation, and the distance. We are given a question on the board, so let us work together the question that is given to us on the board. Okay, the diagram below is a speed time graph of a car. The car starts from rest and accelerates uniformly, starts from rest and accelerates uniformly at 2 meters per second square for t seconds, until it reaches a speed of 16 meters per second. It then travels at 16 meters per second for 40 seconds, after which it comes to rest in a further 10 seconds. Okay, we are asked under A to get the value of t. Which is the time in seconds. Now, the issue is whenever we are asked to get the unknown, for example, we are asked to get the value of t, which is unknown in this case. Whenever we are asked to get the unknown under travel graphs, it means there is always a clue which is given to us to help us find the unknown. So, for example, in our case, we are told that starts from rest and accelerates uniformly at 2 meters per second. So the clue that is given here is about acceleration. So we are told that acceleration is 2 meters per second square. So because the clue that is given to us is about acceleration, therefore we need to use the formula for acceleration to get the unknown value. So what is our formula for acceleration? It says final velocity minus initial over t. So this is the t that we are getting now. So we need just to correct that. We know we are looking at 0 and t. So our final velocity is 16, because at t the speed was 16. So our v is 16 meters per second. Our initial was 0 meters per second, because actually this vehicle started from rest. Okay, so now substituting this information in the formula, we have, so obviously for A we are going to put the acceleration, which is 2. So we shall say 2 is equal to the final velocity is 16, the initial is 0 over t. This is the unknown that we are getting. T is the unknown that we are getting. So you find out to say 2/1 is equal to 16/t. Now, when you have this case, it simply tells you to cross multiply so that you get 2t is equal to 16. When you make t the subject of the formula, you find out that your t is 80 seconds. So actually, our t here is 80 seconds. In fact, for the sake of proving, we can also prove here. When we try to find the acceleration, for example, if we didn't know the acceleration, we know the final velocity, we know the initial, we also need to know t as 8. So we could simply say 16 minus 0 over 8. That definitely will give us 2 as the acceleration. So basically, our t is equal to 8 is correct. Okay. So if at t here we have 8, we are told the car starts from rest and accelerates uniformly at 2 meters per second for t seconds. So now our t is 8. So here we have 8. And until it reaches a speed of 16, it then travels. So it after here, after t, after 8 seconds, it travels at the same speed for 40 seconds. So we have 80 seconds plus 40 seconds within this constant velocity. So we have 8 plus 40. So the time here is supposed to be 48. The time here is supposed to be 48. This 80 plus 40. And after which it comes to rest in a further 10 seconds. So after 48 seconds, it came to rest in a further 10 seconds. So we have 10 plus 48. So we have 58 here as our t here. OK. this is now the full representation of the question that we are, or the statement that we are given. Okay, let's look now at B.
B,
we are told that the distance traveled in the last 50 seconds. So you can see the distance traveled in the last 50 seconds. Here we have our t is 80. Now we are told in the last 50 seconds. So our last 50 seconds just excludes this period of acceleration. So our last 50 seconds just excludes this period of acceleration. So we have to get the area of this rectangular shape and the area of this triangular shape. Then sum them, then we should have gotten the distance in the last 50 seconds. You can see this is 58. If we subtract the first 8 minutes, we shall remain with 50 seconds. So the last 50 seconds is simply this distance. So let's get the distance. We know getting the distance is simply finding the area under a cave. So we shall just find the area under this cave. If we want, we put the, in fact, we shall separate it. We shall separate it. We shall get the area of a rectangle and the area of a triangle. So the area of a rectangle, you can see, so D distance, last 50 seconds, will be given by area of this rectangle. So area of a rectangle is L times B. So we have L here, which is 48 minus 8, which is 40, here times 16. So we have 40 times 16 plus the area of this triangular shape here. Area of this triangular shape. So we have area of a triangle is 1 over 2 times base. Our base is 58 minus 48, which is 10. And our height is 16. So basically, when we sum this, then we would have gotten the area in the last, or the distance in the last 50 seconds. Now, when you're looking at a velocity time graph or a speed time graph, the area under a cave represents the distance. So that's why we are getting the area in the process of getting the distance, because we know if we get the area, then we would have gotten the. Okay, so multiplying that one and adding, we have 40 times 16, we have 640 meters. Plus, this is 2, here is 1, 2 here is 5. And 5 times 16, we have 80. 5 times 16 is giving us 80. So summing the two, 80 plus 640, we have 720 meters. So basically, this is the distance in the last 50 seconds. So in the last 50 seconds. So in the during constant velocity, where the vehicle moved for 40 seconds, the distance that was traveled is 40 by 16, which is 640 meters. Now, during the process of retardation, the distance that was moved is 80 meters. It is 80 meters, which was simplified times 16. Okay. So basically, this is how we get the distance. Okay. Finally, looking at the last part, C, speed of the car when T is equal to 53 seconds. Okay, getting the speed at T is equal to 53 seconds. You can see at T is equal to 53 seconds. This is the period somewhere between 48 seconds and 58 seconds. This is the period between 48 seconds and 50, had already reduced the speed for 5 seconds. It had already reduced the speed for 5 seconds. But it started reducing speed at 48 seconds. Then it, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53. So it had already reduced speed for 5 seconds. So we expect the speed at 53 to be lower than 16 meters per second, because the vehicle was in the process of reducing speed, and it had reduced speed for 5 seconds. So the way we are supposed to answer that question, we are supposed first to get the retardation. So let's get the retardation. We have A is equal to V minus U over T. Okay? So A is equal to, we get the retardation for the whole period. So our final velocity is 0. Our initial is 16. Our T is 10. So our T is 10, 58 minus this one. So that our A is minus 16 over 10. Our A is minus 16 over 10. When you divide throughout by 2, you get minus 8 over 5. So this is the desiration for the whole period during which the vehicle is reducing speed. Okay, so now after getting the deceleration during this period of deceleration, we get the rate of deceleration, we get it this one. We now need now to get the velocity at t. T is equal to 53. So getting the velocity, we shall use the same formula, but this time around we shall make you the subject of the formula, so that we have at is equal to V minus U. And this one comes here, so we have A T plus U is equal to V. So the formula that we shall use is V is equal to A T plus U. Now our acceleration during that period, we have gotten it already, is negative 8 over 5. This is our A during that. And our t, because we are talking about speed at 53 seconds. So our t is basically 58 minus 53, which is 5 seconds. Then finally our u, which is our initial velocity is 16 meters per second. So this is our initial velocity. Then our final velocity will be this speed that we are getting, which we don't know. Then time here will be 58 minus 53. So we have this quantity. So let us put in the formula. We have final velocity is equal to A minus 8 over 5 times T. T is 5 and plus U is 16. So this simply means our V, which is our final velocity, which is our T at, which is our V at 53 seconds, is equal to minus 8 over 5 times 5. We'll simply say 5 there, 1, 5 there, 1, so that we have minus 8 plus 16, which gives us our V as 16 minus 8, which is 80 meters per second. So it means speed at t is equal to 53 seconds is 80 meters per second. So basically, this is how we get the speed when a particular vehicle is accelerating or decelerating. This is how we get the speed of a car when a vehicle or a vehicle when it is in the period of accelerating or decelerating. We need first to find the deceleration or acceleration, then we use it to get the speed at that particular time. It's not like we are supposed to use that odd formula, speed is equal to distance over time here. No, you don't use that one anywhere here. You don't use that one. Okay. You don't use it on a velocity time graph or a speed time graph anywhere here, except when you are getting the average speed. When you are getting the average speed, you use that formula. So average speed is equal to total distance over total time taken. But you don't use it to get the speed when the vehicle is accelerating or decelerating. Thank you very much.